Hello friends, let us start C++ programming. Before going through this programming language, you should know first C language. If you don't know C language, then it is recommended to first successfully complete C language and then go through C++ language. Before starting C++, let us discuss some things, important topics. What happens in case of procedure-oriented programming language, that is C language? Whenever you write a program in C language, then there are a number of functions. If you have a function 1 to function 8, then in that case what happens? Any function can call from any other function. There is open source, or you can simply call any function within any other function. For example, look at the screen. Function 1 is called, or within function 6 is called within function 4. Function 4 is called within function 1, and function 1 is located in main program. That is, in case of C, you have a open approach, or data flow is open while you handling the number of functions. What are the characteristics? Large program are divided into smaller segment known as function. Whenever you write your own functions in case of C programming, then there are modular approach for function. That is, you can split your program into small segments known as function. But in that case, more importance is given to function than data. If I tell you, write a program, or if I tell you, write a function to calculate a factorial, then in case of C, you have to first consider what is a function, how to define function, what type of parameters pass to function. Therefore, there more important is given to function than data. As we see from diagram, data flow is open. Therefore, we don't have data security constraint. Data move freely around function to function. That is, if you declare the global variable, then that type of variable is available within any type of function block. That is what function transfer data from one function to another directly. It is known as unnatural flow. Why unnatural flow? Because you have to first call function and then define the function part. Therefore, it is known as an unnatural flow. Hence, in case of C, real-time applications are not developed because this type of applications are not very well managed. Programming approach is from top to bottom. It means your first main program is get executed and then your function part is get executed, and data structure is complicated. If you write a data flow diagram of your C program, and if you want to add one function, or if you want to remove a function from that program, then whole programming flow get changed, and that's why data structure is complicated. Let us compare this point to a object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming is what? OOP. In this case, what happens? You have a number of objects, and the communication between these objects is carried out by using function. What are these techniques? Let us discuss. In case of object-oriented programming language, more important is given on data than the functions. If in case of object, what is mean by OOP? Or what is meant by object-oriented programming? Before that, you should know about object. Object means real-time entity. For example, if we take an example of vehicle class, vehicle is a class and car is an object of that class. It means what? If you have a ready set of class, then only there is object is created. That's why whenever you want to create an object, then before creating the object, you must have a design of class. That is, you must define the data and function. For example, if I tell you to create a class of bank, Then we first take a data, account number, name, balance, etc. And then write a function. Therefore, first important is given to a data, then the function. Object class means what? Class is a collection or class is a set of data and related functions. Related data and related function. For example, class of bank must contain a data and function related to bank, open account, update account, etc. If you want to create a class of student, then there are functions show student, list student, result, etc. If you have a class of employee, then it must contain a employee details and the functions, bonus, payslip, etc. That is, class is a set or class is a unit in which data and functions are defined. Therefore, whenever you want to create a class, the emphasis is on data than the function. Program are divided into what are known as object. If you have a class of employee and you want to create a file object, then each object has its own details. Therefore, your program, or in short, you can, whenever you create a number of objects, then you create a copy of given class. Data structures are designed such that they are categorized the object. Functions that are operate on the data of object are bind together in the data structure. Here in diagram, this is object 1 and object 2. Each object contains a data and function. And then object communication is performed by using functions. Data are hidden and cannot be accessed by external function. Whenever you create a class, then there are access modifiers, private, public, and protected. If your data is private, then that type of data cannot be accessed by a external entity. Therefore, data is always hidden. But you can be made accessible this data by using public functions. Object may communicate with each other through function. Directly communication of object is not possible. Therefore, you must communicate the object by using function. New data and function can be easily added whenever necessary. If you want to add some functions or data to a class, then it is very easily added to a class. Follow bottom-up approach in programming design. That is, while creating the program, you have to first create a class and then write your main program and create the objects within that program. Therefore, approach is always bottom-up. First main is get executed and then classes get implemented. It is a technique of OOP. It is a characteristic of OOP. What is the history of C++? Before that, okay. And OOP or C++ is one of the basic application of OOP technology. Here is the simple history of C++. C is a basic language. Plus plus is an increment operator. And therefore, it is a step forward language to C. Therefore, it is known as a C++. Initially, it is called a C with classes. Then, the given name C++. Bjarne Tostrup is a founder of C++ language. Here, they only include a class. It is found in 1983 in Bell Laboratory, USA. You need some basic things from C language. For example, keywords, identifier, constants, string operators, all these things are covered under a C language. Here also 46 keywords are available in CPP. The new keywords which are not present in C are the friend function, friend or class, private, protected, etc. These keywords are not available in case of C, but these are available in case of C++. Data types are used as it is. You had used this type of data types in case of C or while performing C programs. Integer contain integer, float character, then there is structure type defining, and one more is class. And within data, there are array and pointer. Memory allocation is also same. If you have a data of integer type, then it allocates 2 bytes in memory and its range is same as a C language. Or if you want to float data, then its range is again same as a C language. All these things are same. But what are the principles of OOP? What is meant by object-oriented programming language? While we're talking about object-oriented programming, you have to first clear the two things. What is class and what is object? What is object? But object is an entity or object is an instance of class. Therefore, you first know the class. For example, as I have said, class of vehicle, the object is car, bike, or the class of fruit, the objects are mango, grapes, pineapple. That is, object means a real-time entity. If you have a class, then only there is object. For example, you are also object of human being. It means what? Human being class is already defined and you are an object of human being. From this point, we have to clear before creating object, there is very compulsion to create a class. And in case of or from the programming point of view, in class, we have a number of data and functions related to that data. And all these data and functions related to a particular thing. For example, bank, animal, employee, etc. Then how to define class? Class is a collection of object or class is a collection of or unit of data and functions. Object is a real-time entity. If you have a class of student and whenever you create object, then only that class is get utilized. For example, you open your new bank and whenever the customer open the account, then only that type of structure is get utilized. Like this here, if you have a class with appropriate data and function, but this class is useful only when you create a object. Without object, class does not utilize. The next principle is data encapsulation and abstraction. Whenever you create a class, then you must have an abstract idea of particular thing. For example, if I tell you to create a class of student, then you must have the student data, what are the functions, all these things are you have to design first and then create a object. And why encapsulation? Because data and function are encapsulated within the class. Class is known as a single unit. Therefore, while you creating the class or in case of OOP, object-oriented programming, you have a facility to data encapsulation and abstraction. Inheritance. In case of inheritance, you have a multiple level of classes. And you can also modify the level of classes in terms of main level and sub-level. Polymorphism. Poly means many, morphism means form. It means what? You can, in case of OOP or in case of any language of OOP, you can write a overloading operations. That is, if you have an area of function of area, then you can write the three functions which will calculate the area of rectangle, circle and square. And all the it is possible that all these three functions have the same name. Why? Because polymorphism give you a way to create a function by using the same name but different set of argument as well as different type of definition or signature. Dynamic memory management through a constructor and destructor. These two functions are new in C++ or in case of OOP, not in C++ only. In case of any OOP language, you have a facility of constructor and destructor. Constructor function is used to construct object as soon as it is declared, whereas destructor function is used to destroy object from memory after the utilization of object. All these principles are applied to all type of programming languages. What are the programming languages? C++, Java, .NET, all this considered as a OOP or object-oriented programming language. Here is the brief description. What is a class? It is a collection of object. For example, if you have a class, then human being, vehicle, fruit. You can also write to object of this class. But each class contains its own properties and its own functionality. Object. Object is a real-time entity. If you don't have an object, there is not possible to utilize the structure of given class. By creating object, in short, you create a copy of class. If you have a class of student, has data of roll number, name, total percentage, and if you have a 10 student, 20 student, 50 student, then it means what? Each student has the same data, roll number, name, total percentage. That is, by using number of objects, you can create a copy of class or instance of class. As we discuss data encapsulation, in case of OOP, data is highly secure from direct access. Why direct access? Because there are some access modifiers are available, private and protected. Therefore, if you want to create a data or if you want to use a data, then you have a function. That is, data is used under the function, and function is called by using the objects. Indirectly, object use the data but through a public functions. As well as, every class has a data abstraction feature. It is means what? Before creating actual object, it is necessary to design the abstract idea of class that include the various functionality, related data, which is finally adopted by the object of given class. Inheritance. By using this principle, it is possible to extend the existing class into a new class. That is, in this case, you have a multiple classes, or you can also make a hierarchy of classes. By using this principle, we have a reusability of code. The code which is already under existence, there is no need to create the all over again. To avoid unnecessary coding already under existence, you can also make a hierarchy of classes by classifying the design of application in terms of main and sub-level. And it is also used to reduce the complexity within the program. If you have a number of level of classes, then it is very easy to understand the program. Polymorphism. For example, as I have gave you a example of area function, here the example of addition function. The name of these functions are same, only the type of argument are different. As well as definition is also different, because this function return the integer value, this function return the float, and this is also return the float, but it has two float as a parameters. It is known as a overloading operation. It is possible in OOP language to create a overloading operations. C++, Smalltalk, Object Pascal, Java, .NET, all these considered as a object oriented programming language. That is, we have discussed some technical, some principles of OOP, and all these principles are available in these languages. Therefore, C++ is a basic of object oriented programming technique, and in the current day, object oriented programming is a uppermost layer of programming languages. Visual Basic 6 and IDEA are the object based programming language. What is the difference between object oriented and object based? In case of object based, you have a ready-made set of classes, properties and functions. But in case of object-oriented, you have a ready-made set, as well as you can create your own class, your own properties and functions. It is the difference between these two languages. Here is the It is not a new part for you, because we had already used this type of operators under C language. But some operators are new. For example, scope resolution operator. This operator we will use whenever we define a member function of class outside the class. And one more is insertion extraction operator, we use for input and output operations. And all these operations operators are used under a C language also. You know the structure. Then what is the difference between structure and class? The structure has only data items, but the function has data items as well as function. All the variables and the function declared in a class, whether it is public or private section, are the members of class. And in structure, all the elements by default are public. That is, you can access any member of structure within the main program or within any type of function. But in case of class, it is always declared under the some access specifier, that is public or private. What is meant by stream? Stream means a continuous group of data or channel through which data travels from one point to another. Here we have a two type of stream, input stream and output stream. As name implies, input stream is used to receive the data and output stream is used to send data to a destination. That is, in simple language, input stream is used to take input from user, output stream is used to print a output. That is, input stream is, if you want to compare it with C, then input stream is like a printf function, like a scanf function, and output stream is like a printf function. But here we have classes for this. Standard input output in CPP is presented by the two objects, C in console input and C out console output. That is, this object is used for input purpose and this is for output purpose. These two objects are a member of IOS class, that is input output stream classes. Let us see the hierarchy. Here is the IOS. IOS is a combination of iStream and OStream, input stream and output stream. Cin is object of iStream and Cout is object of OStream. And commonly we call this as IOStream. It means what? These objects are used to take a input and to print a output. And as we know that every program must consist of input and output operation. Therefore, it is very compulsion to always include iostream.h header file for every program of C++. But how to use these operators? As we know that whenever you want to perform input operation, then you have to input data from input device keyboard. Then with the help of Cin object, along with insertion operator, this data will store in memory location. The syntax is too simple. Cin, insertion operator and variable name. Here you don't have a format specifier. If you forget the format specifier, then also there is no problem. Here you need only variable name. If you want a scan number of variable, then Cin, insertion operator variable 1, insertion operator variable 2, insertion operator variable number n, and give the semicolon at the end. If you want to print output, then read the value from memory location with the help of extraction operator with cout object, and then it will print on output device. Here is also simple syntax cout extraction operator variable. And if you want to print a sum statement, then cout extraction operator, double quotes, double inverted comma, give your message, inverted comma complete and semicolon. There is a simple way. Let us see the program. Here is the simple program. Your favorite program. Program to print sum of two numbers. Isn't it? Then you must include iostream header file and one more . Now here we don't want to create a class, we want to perform the programming from basic. Therefore, here is the simple program of addition of two number. How to perform this program by using C++? Here you have a n1, n2 and n3. Okay, you know that how to print output or how to print message, double inverted comma, slash n, give error message, enter two numbers. Then there is Cin, scan number 1 and there is number 2. And now print, perform the process and simply print the output. Sum. here is the simple program. If you notice that only instead of printf scanf we have used here c out and c in. First save this program. Oh, there is N3. Okay. Now run it. Enter two numbers. You will get the answer. Okay. By carefully studying this program, you can perform programs like C, addition, multiplication, subtraction, division, or area of circle, area of rectangle, like this. Because only instead of printf scanf, you have to write C out and C in and follow the this syntax. Here the input, process and output. But I must tell you the some new things which are available or new technique available in C++. These are some new concept. The first concept is dynamic declaration and definition. What is mean by dynamic declaration? Because in CPP, you have a way to declare variable at any place within the program, as well as you can be utilize the variable at the same place where it is declared. It is known as dynamic declaration and definition. Again, I repeat, in case of CPP, it is possible to declare variable at any place within the program, as well as you can be utilize the variable at the same place where it is declared. This concept is known as dynamic declaration and definition. Let us see this concept within the program. For example, in this program, if you want to declare the dynamic N3, then it is possible to declare N3 here. It is known as dynamic declaration and definition. Okay, again run the program, you will get the same output. Let us again create the one more program. The program is again you have to include IOStream and one more is Conio. Okay. For marksheet, you must need some variables. Here, if we assume variable as roll number, marks of 3 subject. Here is no need to declare the variable for output because we have a facility of dynamic declaration and definition. Okay, first take a input part. Enter name. It is also simple syntax right here, sname, and here at a time we scan a marks of 3 subject. Then give here your variables for marks. Okay, now dynamically declare here total, which is you can also first declare and then define the variable. For example, float percentage, then percentage is equal to total divided by number of subjects. That is it is known as dynamic declaration and then definition. It is known as dynamic declaration and definition. And now simply print the output. You can also print here roll number, name, marks, but I print here only a total and percentage. For practice purpose, it is always better to perform all these basic programs you have already done in case of C language. Or I already tell you addition, subtraction, multiplication, area, Celsius, Fahrenheit, temperature, all this program you can easily perform in case of C. It is always better to perform all this program for better practice. Now save it. I give here name prog02. Okay, run it. Here is the total and percentage. Like this, you can perform any type of program with the help of Cout and Cin. Let us perform one more program. Program to print. For this program, we have used or we will use for loop. Here declare, or you don't need to declare anything. You simply want to print a 1 to 10 number. Therefore, for you can also declare dynamically variable here, integer I equal to 1, I is less than equal to 10, and I plus plus. And you can simply print here Cout I. You can also give a new operator for end line, that is endl. Instead of slash n, you can also use a endl. If you want to use a slash n, then give the double inverted comma and then use a slash n. Here is the output. That is, you can dynamically declare the variable like this. Or if we want to print a static graph, then it is also a simple logic. If I give here 5, for static graph we need a asterisk symbol, then give here star. Here the inner loop get close, within outer loop there is Cout endl, or if you want to give a slash n, then doesn't matter, slash n, or you can also write a endl. Here is the output. Okay, that is, by using this new concept, dynamic declaration and definition, you can perform all basic C programs, that is program of if, or you can also go through a sequence, simple program, then program of if, then switch, then while, then for, do while. Like this, you can perform programs by using concept of dynamic declaration and definition. Okay, in the next program, we will discuss more concept. Thank you.